CBS Sports welcomes you live to Jordan-Hare Stadium in Auburn, Alabama. NASDAQ college football continues with a huge battle in the Southeastern Conference between number 7 Florida at 5-1, coming off a loss last week at LSU, and number 6 Auburn with a perfect record of 6-0. Auburn trying to avenge last year's pummeling at the hands of the Gators in Gainesville, 51-10. Florida won the toss and deferred. Auburn elected to receive in the first half.
Very conservative. They didn't want to make a mistake with the ball in this area of the field.
Jarrett Holmes, the punter. Jacquez Green fielded it on a bounce at his own 47. And he's tackled at the 43-yard line of Auburn by Brent Turner. Much of his action in the games against Central Michigan, a game in which he went 4-for-4, and against Arkansas in a blowout win, he was 5 out of 10, but threw 2 touchdowns.
Looks like he's checking off to a quick pass.
Palmer on 2nd and 12. His first pass on target to Jamie Richardson. Some fancy footwork, and a first down for Florida. Down to the 30-yard line. Brad Ware made the tackle for Auburn, a gain of 14. Playing for the injured Zach Piller out with a hamstring injury. On 1st and 10. On a blitz come the Tigers. The pass caught by Taylor with running room. Fred Taylor breaking tackles. And he's down at the 7-yard line. Gain of 23. The right defensive end, Leonardo Carson, way downfield to make the tackle.
Who are further removed from the quarterback to hear the snap count.
You mentioned the tackling. Bill Oliver, the defensive coordinator for Auburn, told us yesterday that last week in the win over Louisiana Tech, his team was the worst tackling team in the United States. And he says Florida is the best at run after catch. Jacquez Green throws, touchdown! Jamie Richardson taking the pass from the former option quarterback in high school, Jacquez Green, and the Gators open impressively with the new quarterback at the helm.
Has better field position here, Sean, so consequently they come out in their spread formation trying to thin out that Florida defense.
George coming on a blitz, and it's Javon Kearse with the sack, the first of the game for Florida. Craig thrown down back inside the 30. Loss of 7 on that play. Nearly 5 minutes gone by first quarter. Florida leads 7-0. And George came on a blitz. This time the ball's knocked free. And it looks like Florida has recovered. The Gators have. John Exnitis came on the blitz and knocked it free. And Reggie McGrew recovered the fumble.
The Auburn defense.
He ran right by the new tight end, Dwight Edge, who started the season as the third string tight end. Collins Cooper. Where he says he doesn't attempt many field goals. This is a 22-yard try. And it is good. Florida, historically very strong, bouncing back from rare defeats, off to a strong start today. Florida has bounced back very well after a defeat in the regular season over the last 4 years. For each of the losses, they've bounced back with a win, sometimes in convincing fashion. They've been impressive so far with the true freshman Jesse Palmer at quarterback. He's been asked to do very little of a fancy nature. He throws a play-action pass, and that's a bullet to Jacquez Green. And he's down with a first down at the 23-yard line. Outstanding field position here in the first quarter for Florida.
As fast as he could and hit the receiver. Right now, this freshman, who has had spring practice, I reiterate, is sure playing awfully well for the Gators.
Gators go without a huddle. Same spread formation. Blitz again. Up for grabs and picked off. Brad Ware for Auburn. Taken down by Jacquez Green at midfield. Has the lead over Auburn late in the first quarter. Sean McDonough with Terry Donahue. Boy, Florida had everything going its way, Terry, until that big turnover.
Well, the big turnover by the freshman quarterback, but Auburn's had such poor field position. Finally, they're in good field position, which allows them to run a little more of their offense.
Craig lofts it up. It is caught. The tight end, Kevin McLeod. First down, Auburn, at the 15-yard line.
Leading receiver at Auburn, he needs to come up with this catch. This is a great throw by Dameyune Craig. He had Elijah Williams beat. He just needs to come up with that play.
Gators showing blitz again. Rutledge is coming. Over the middle. Caught. And it is a touchdown for Tyrone Dillard.
Bring that heat. That is when this defense is overwhelming.
Second and 12. 10-7. Florida has the lead. 8:40 remaining in the first half. Blitz again from Ixnaitis. Craig gets out of the grasp of Curse, and then Ixnaitis got back into the play to bury him. And a huge loss. The fifth sack already for the Florida defense, and the play goes all the way back to the 37-yard line.
I don't want to say I told you so, but sure enough, blindsided, chased around out of the pocket, and he's been under real duress.
New tailback, the true freshman, DeMontre Carter, who's already a fan favorite. He made his collegiate debut last week against Louisiana Tech and sparked the offense. He spins out of a tackle, and that's a first down for Auburn out to the 27-yard line.
First down.
Time a factor now, a minute 25 remaining in the first half. Auburn has just one timeout left. The throw by Craig on the mark. First down, Auburn. Karsten Bailey tackled by Elijah Williams.
And again, credit the Auburn backs. They stayed in and protected. They max protected that time and gave Dameyune Craig the time he needed.
He did not get out of bounds, so the clock is running. The pass caught. Nice move in traffic by Beasley. He's in bounds at the Florida 40-yard line, tackled by Keith Kelsey. They stop the clock to move the chains, but it'll run again once they set the chains.
Caught a difficult ball for the first down.
Clock down to 47 seconds left of the half. One timeout remaining for Auburn. Craig deep down the middle. Caught by Baylor. First down, Tigers. 23-yard line. Fred Weary made the tackle.
Sean, what's happened is the Auburn offense has made an adjustment.
Third down and 10, 20 seconds left in the half. Florida leads 10-7. Craig with a lot of time. Throws, it is caught inside the five. The clock will stop on the reception by Goodson, which gives him a first down. 14 seconds left, the clock will run. I think this is the right move, Terry.
Absolutely.
No guarantee you're going to get another play. It'll be very deflating for an underdog team to come out of this situation with no points when they had a chance to go in tied at the break.
No, I think this is absolutely the right call.
20-yard field goal try by Jared Holmes. It is good. And it's halftime in Auburn, Alabama. Here's Michelle Tafoya.
Coach, sit
down to that touchdown pass and to the field goal after they got their protection solved.
Six sacks in the first half for Florida. 15-yard gain on the first play for the Gators. That pass intercepted. Another high throw and another pickoff by Brad Ware. His first interception changed the momentum of the game. His second has Auburn in business to start the second half.
And he excites this stadium, and that helps you in this kind of a game.
Third down. You need to get just inside the 27 for another first down. It's a short five to go. Craig sidesteps Rogers. Now Javon Kearse strips the football, and it goes out of bounds at the 50-yard line. Huge loss on the play. They were in field goal range for a long try from Jared Holmes, but that is no longer the case. Knowledge of the offense.
And I think it was interesting when Michelle was talking to Steve. Steve said, hey, we may play a little different this half. I think this is what he meant, with a different quarterback, maybe change the tempo of the game, take some pressure off that young freshman, and then go ahead and maybe put him back in the game later.
Draw, running room for Taylor. First down as he's across the 15-yard line. Tripped up by Rob Pate.
In big games, oftentimes the defenses step up. You expect a high-scoring game, but the defenses start making plays, and all of a sudden you're in a struggle defensively.
Each turnover was key. It led to a score by the opposition in the first half. Taylor, close to another first down out of the 27-yard line. Ryan Taylor, no relation, made the tackle on Fred Taylor. Key interceptions, although the second one did not result in Auburn points. Nearly 4 minutes played, third quarter, 10-10 the score. Brindise, a wobbly pass, but it's on target, and it beats Kareem. And that's a first down for the Gators in Auburn territory at the 46-yard line. Brad Ware made the tackle on the junior from Marietta, Georgia, and Nafis Kareem. Five wide receivers in the game for Florida. On third down, nearly 10 to go for a first down. They're showing blitz. Taylor came on a blitz. That pass is caught by Travis McGriff for a first down. They beat the blitz. Antoine Nolan made the tackle, but the Gators continue the drive.
By the Auburn secondary.
Now third and 10. Out of the shotgun, Brindise throws. McGriff with another catch for a first down. He beat Antoine Nolan on the coverage. McGriff came in. Big play here, Terry.
Well, Steve Spurrier likes to throw to the corners of the end zone down here, so be careful with Jacquez Green and Jamie Richardson down to those corners.
On third and three, touchdown, Jacquez Green! Two minutes played, fourth quarter.
Hard to beat Florida. When they run for 100 yards, they're hard to beat because they have it going both in the run and in the throwing game.
And Taylor has it going. It's the defense of Auburn that looks tired now as Taylor's down to the 32-yard line. Rob Pate made the tackle. 16 more on the rush for Taylor. We saw him. It looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. They do not have a great field goal kicker in Cooper Collins. Collins Cooper, pardon me.
Steve Spurrier is going to try to get the ball to those wide receivers. In this kind of a situation with this kind of yardage, you've got to go ahead and throw it outside to those wideouts.
Fourth and six in a seven-point game. The pass deflected and it falls incomplete. Time running out for Terry Bowden's offense to get on track. When we spoke with the Auburn coach yesterday, he said, we're going to play it the way we usually do. Spread the field, throw the ball all over the place. Well, they're almost 50-50 today, run pass, a team that hasn't run the ball all year.
Yeah, it hasn't gone the way Terry thought it would, and I think you got to credit the Florida defense. The pressure has been really extreme.
Fumbled by Goodson after the catch, picked up by Fred Weary. And he is still on his feet. Weary inside the 10. And down to the 7-yard line. Mike Peterson knocked the ball free from Tyrone Goodson. A huge turnover by the Tigers with 5:16 remaining.
Offense and for the team, they've turned turnovers for them. They do a great job ripping the ball loose and stripping it.
Second and goal from the 5. 4:35 remaining. This time they do hand it off, and it's Jacquez Green to the end zone. Touchdown! Second down and 15. Again, Willie Rogers again.
Exactly the same move. He took it to the inside again. With the Florida athletes, the reality is they're good enough to do it.
That's right. Hard
to get off that coverage.
Bill Oliver, the defensive coordinator for Auburn, refers to the personnel for Florida, the athletes, as Rolls-Royce personnel. Craig deep in his own end zone on third down and 30. Jump ball. It's intercepted by Tico Brown. He has a lot of running room to the near side. And goes down inside the 10-yard line. Clifton Robinson made the tackle. Well, one more snap. And that will likely do it. You see the game clock at 8, play clock at 4. Taylor. Stopped short of the goal line. And time expires. Steve Spurrier and the Florida Gators bounce back from that loss at LSU last Saturday night with a solid victory. It wasn't in true Florida fashion. The fun and gun was somewhat subdued on offense, but the defense was outstanding. And Noah Brindise came off the bench to engineer a 97-yard touchdown drive that put Florida ahead this day. Here's